we're going to talk about being justified and made righteous in Christ. So many believers struggle with this, and what we're going to hear today is going to really help set us free from that and teach us how we are supposed to live out of our new identity in Jesus. So how does God see you? When God sees you, He sees you as somebody who's without blame. Those words without blame simply mean to be faultless, to be blameless or unblameable, without blemish, without spot. This is how God sees us. As we develop this further, we also must understand that not only are we holy and without blame before Him in love, but we are accepted in the Beloved. We must understand that we are washed, sanctified, and justified. And that's what we want to talk about, want to emphasize today about being justified. You know, to be justified means to be acquitted. That means to be made free of all charge. There are no more charges against you. You are justified, completely acquitted, cleared of all guilt, all judgment. There's no more conviction against you. You're justified. So in the New Testament, there are two words, justified, and you also read about being made righteous, righteous. Now, both the words justified and righteous, they come from the same Greek word, and therefore they mean the same thing. To be justified means to be made righteous. That means you are in right standing before God. When God justified us, God made us righteous. He gave us His own righteousness. That means we have become the righteousness of God, or we have been made righteous with the righteousness that comes from God Himself. We have become what? The righteousness of God in Him, in Christ. So in Christ, you and I have become the righteousness of God because God put that to us. Now think about this. There is no other way that we can have fellowship with God, because for God to have fellowship or a close friendship or intimate relationship with any being, that being, we have to be on par with God's righteousness. So the only way God could have fellowship with us is by giving us His own righteousness. Righteousness, there are three aspects to righteousness. So when you talk about righteousness, we talk about right standing. That means you can stand right before God. Righteousness also has to do with the right quality of nature, has to do with character. That means you are a righteous person. And righteousness also has to do with right behavior. That means you're doing right things. This righteousness, we've been justified and made righteous through faith. All that God wanted us to do, say, I want you to have faith. If you have faith in Jesus, I'll make you righteous. Another important thing to emphasize is that we've been justified freely by His grace. So this justification, being justified and made righteous, it's through faith and it's by grace. And the reason God can do that is because He has justified and made us righteous by His blood. That means the price Jesus paid, we are justified by His blood. Oh, the price Jesus paid is on the basis of which God is saying, I'm declaring you righteous. So you understand your identity. Before God, you are justified. You are made righteous. That's who you are now. You're accepted in the Beloved. You're no longer a sinner. You're no longer dirty. You've been washed. You're no longer unworthy. He's honored you. He's favored you. He's graced you. He's blessed you. So that's your identity. How do you live out of it? What does it mean to you and me in everyday life? I want to mention a few things taught to us in Scripture. First of all, we must understand that there is no condemnation. Secondly, understand this, that we have boldness to enter into God's presence because we've been made righteous, because we've been justified. We have boldness to enter the presence of God. Thirdly, because we have been justified, the Bible says in Romans 5, verse 17, that we can reign in life. The gift of righteousness is also our armor before the enemy. It's the armor. You see, you have something Satan doesn't have. You have righteousness. And the Bible says, put on the breastplate of righteousness. Take on the armor of righteousness. righteousness is a weapon against the enemy. Lastly, in closing, remember, we must fellowship with God in righteousness. That is important because righteousness not only gives us a right standing before God, but it has called us, put us in this place where we live, that we have the quality of being righteous, and we live out of that righteousness. We walk in righteousness.